Hi, welcome to the fifth video in my Protractor tutorial series. And in this video, we are going to talk about Jasmine framework, because Jasmine is something that you start hearing whenever you start getting know about Protractor. Everyone talks about Jasmine, that it follows the Jasmine framework, but what exactly is Jasmine framework? So before we start writing the test automation scripts, I personally want you guys to know that what basically Jasmine is. So Jasmine is basically a framework. Jasmine is a behavior-driven development framework for testing JavaScript code. So whenever you want to test any JavaScript code and if you want to use a framework, then Jasmine, Mocha and Cucumber are the some options which is available as a framework. So Jasmine is the default framework available for the Protractor. So whenever you start writing the Protractor script, you'll have to use Jasmine framework. Whereas it's not mandatory that you have to use Jasmine only, it's just that this is the default framework available for Protractor scripts. So Jasmine is the default framework for Protractor. Jasmine has no external dependencies. Jasmine is open source and Jasmine documentations are available at the mentioned path. So if you want to know more about the Jasmine framework and the keywords and the methods available in Jasmine framework, you can directly visit the link and you will get to know about each and everything. But in this video, we are also going to talk about the same thing. So you don't have to go anywhere. Just stick to our video. The global methods which is available in the Jasmine framework is before all, after all, before each, after each, describe, it, expect, fail, and there are some other like for focused, there are some other methods available, but these are the main methods that you'll have to know, you'll have to understand in order to put a proper structure and framework in your Protractor script. So first of all, describe, because describe and it is the most popular and the most used method of the Jasmine framework. So first we are going to begin with the describe block. So this is the syntax. This is how you'll have to write the describe block. So once you describe the describe method, you'll have to put a description. It could be anything. You just have to put it inside a single quote and then you'll have to design one definition, and usually you'll have to put the function here. So what it does is it creates a group of specifications, often called a suite. So it creates a suite. If you have to create a suite of the test cases, you simply have to create a describe, and every test case must be inside the describe block. It calls to describe can be nested within other calls to compose your suite as a tree. So one suite can be defined inside the another suite. So it means you can use the nested describe blocks to create a structure or to create a tree of the suites. And these are the parameters. You'll have to put the description in the strings and you'll have to define the specification in the form of functions. So once you're done with the describe block, you'll have to create one it block inside the describe. So it block basically refers to the test cases. So for each test case, you'll have to define one it block, and inside the it block, you'll have to put all the steps that you have to do in order to do one automation. And once you're done with writing the steps, you'll have to put some assertions, and in order to assert something and to make your test case pass or fail, you'll have to put the expect statement to verify and to assert the values. So how it looks like, you'll have to write the it, and inside the bracket you'll have to put a description, then the function, and then a timeout. But these two options are optional. It's not mandatory that every time you define one it block, you'll have to put a function or timeout. So what it does is it defines a single specification. A specification should contain one or more expectations that test the state of the code. A specification whose expectations all succeed will be passing, and a specification with the failure will fail. So once the expectation is passed, then your whole test case will be passed. If the expectation is not matching with the defined condition, then it will fail. Now have a look of the description. So description, you'll have to put in the string. So it could be anything, whatever you want to put inside that. So you can simply put your test case name or something like that, so that it can denote your test case. And then you'll have to define one function, and inside that function you'll have to write all the steps that you want to follow, and expect condition that you have to match to pass or fail your test case. And then comes your timeout. Timeout is again optional. You'll have to put the value in milliseconds, and once that timeout period is elapsed, then only it will start throwing the timeout error. Before each, and the syntax is before each. Inside functions, you inside the parenthesis, you'll have to pass function and timeout, but both options are optional. So it runs some shared setup before each of the specification in the describe in which it is called. So what happens, whatever you write inside the before each block, it will be executed before starting any describe block statement. So what happens, you can again see this, it runs some shared setup before each of the specifications in the describe in which it is called. So it will be executed before each it block inside the describe block. Similarly for after each, so after each again you will have to define the functions and timeout in the parenthesis. It runs after the each it block inside your describe block. So let's say that there are two test cases, and if you want to perform certain action before and after executing each test cases, then you'll have to use before each and after each. So that's the purpose of after each. And then comes it before all. So before all defines a function and timeout. So inside the before all, you'll have to define the pre-setup that you want to execute before starting the test execution. So what happens? It runs some shared setup once before all of the specifications in the described are run. So the code which is written inside the before all block will be executed in the very beginning and before executing any test case in your script. And then comes your after all. So after all is done, after all is used to perform the cleanup activity. So once your test execution is completed, and if you want to close the browser and if you want to do any other cleanup activity, then you will have to use the after all statement. And inside the after all block, whatever you will be written, that will be executed at the completely end of the test execution. So inside this, in this video, that's all. And in my next video, I'll be using all of these methods, which is inside the Jasmine framework, and I'll be demonstrating you that how you can use all of these statements. Thanks for watching.